Yes, that'll work. That will work. Here, I'll stick them. There. Oh, actually, that'll actually fire the missiles. Apparently, I missed some pipes somewhere. Bloody hell, I'm gonna have to check all my piping. Annoying. Let's see. Hard to slap that one down. Slap it in right over here. Yeah. And now This is going to be my smoke deploying system. With the bloody hell. Does not save? It did save. Okay. We're good. With the complex controller, I hit my L key, smoke deploys. Temporary measure. While I get everything else in order. There'll be smoke. And this, pretty sure this is high enough to actually keep clear. Oh yeah. And this also puts me over 10,000 blocks. Stuff is breaking? What? Close enough. Okay, what was the other thing I was going to work on? Let's see what's out there. There is
receiving. Moving
pretty much
now.
Nothing out there. Let's go see if anyone's over here. Oh, that's a resource zone, but whose is it? I do not remember. Squeeze. Reconnections, yes.
Awaiting new order.
Let's see, where are they? There they are. Six of each. Two, three. Six. Okay, so that should be 10 of each. Should be. Yeah, 10 of each. Ooh, fun. Wonder if Abby is watching. So if I remember right, Alcazar was originally one of his. Let me go poke him in Discord. Okay. Confirmed it in Discord. Yeah. Alcazar is not spawned in. Have a ship go that way. Well, I came over and take a look. See what's actually in there. Hey, that was a. I forgot the name. Pinnacle, yes. It was a P something. Really a cute little ship. At least when it hasn't had its front end blown off entirely. Jeez. Oh, oh my god. Oh jeez. See if I can put it out of its misery. Nope, going for the other thing. Well, pretty sure that's probably dead. Right now, it's still alive. The bastard. How dare it? Do another missile volley.
Awaiting new orders.
Yeah, let's reposition over yonder. Apparently not. Cute. Any moment now, my ammo should kill it. Okay, maybe not. What the hell? That was clearly in view of the missile warners, yet the lands have been not wanting to fire on missiles. I fire on crams just fine. But missiles? No, not really. I have no idea why. Yep. I should probably fix my torpedoes real quick. Now that I did confirm that the staggered fire add-ons are in fact working. Guess I just didn't have enough of them prior. Or something, I don't know. Heading back this way. Get some cruise missiles going. IR's going. I have no idea what the hell those are doing. Alcazar's having some difficulty. Oh. Herp-de-derp. Back to defaults. Segment updated for detection? Yes, it has. Possibly. In theory. Oops. Oh, guess the IRs did. Or wait, which are these? Now these are radar guided. IR came straight in. Maybe? I don't even know.
Awaiting new orders.
Yep, torpedoes. Get in a bit closer there. Get the cruise missiles launched. There we go. This Alcazar is having a bad day.
Awaiting new orders.
If this thing was, I really can't tell if this thing was updated with detection. If it was, it didn't do very well. Still a lot of torpedoes in the water. Well, not too many. Man, resources. I still need even more resources. What the heck am I gonna do with all these? Have not been able to build up my ship fast enough with all the resources I'm getting. Huh. Going to slap on.
Moving now.
What is that? Only 1,000 accessible with. That's actually. Considering the growth of all the other spots, that's actually rather decent. Yeah, I can head that way.
Moving now.
All right then. not know why the game was complaining about exhaust earlier. Almost all of my detection capability, right there. So far, I've managed to only take one cram hit to the sensor mast. Only one. That was before I'd upsize the lambs, so hopefully that won't happen again, but it probably will. What? Trespassing. What? He's... Oh crap.
Moving now. Moving
Don't
now.
Want to piss him off yet. No! Turn around! Turn around! Oh god! I don't want to piss them off yet. Oh shit. Oh god, oh god. Damn it, ship. Go south, south! Go south, you bastard! Oh, son of a bitch. Oh, this is gonna hurt. Well, shit. Or if bribing still works. Let's find out. That is Sist Riders. Yeah, that's Sist Riders. Wait. Okay. Yeah, I am not quite ready to tackle Steel Riders. As for the that smoke maker thing, that was part of a the decor mod. Supposedly it was supposed to hook up with exhaust, but it might be slightly out of date or something. So, I don't know. And I am at war with someone. I'm at war with Onyx Watch. Technically, I'm still at war with Deepwater Guard, but I've wiped out all their headquarters and shipyards. So I'm pretty sure I got them all. Their main one's definitely wiped out. And the Onyx Watch still has their main headquarters, which I should probably start working towards. And I am planning on either White Flares, or possibly Lightning Hoods next. Haven't decided. Possibly Lightning Hoods, now that I got my smoke system in. Let's see. Onyx Watch headquarters should be here-ish, if I remember correctly. Oh, come on.
Moving now.
Remember my selection once in a while. Jeez. Ah. Okay, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna armor the bow. Slap some metal on just underneath the surface. Little beams everywhere. As I finish this section, let's see if I see anybody coming. Whoops, what the hell did I just delete? A metal beam. Okay, there we go. Let's see, anybody? Take a peek at Discord chat. And back in the game. Any moment now. Let's see what we got. House Dave. Mule.
Awaiting
and
order.
Something really tiny. Pinnacle. House Dave. I know I've fought those before, I just cannot remember what they look like. Mule is thinking that's more of a cargo ship. Huh. All right. Okay, whatever. Missiles away. Regular missiles away. AI is handling the cannons and torpedo systems. Okay, so this is the mule. Yeah, it kinda is a cargo ship, kinda. Is that the pal stave? Yeah, that's the pal stave. Which did not last long. God, these things are so damn cute. And this one's still very much dead. Weapon systems are. Well, that cannon's almost completely shot away. Its missiles are all damaged beyond workability. Those aren't even firing. And those are torpedoes.
Awaiting new order.
Yep. Baby castles. Though I did have an earlier fight, two nights ago. Had a fleet of two bulwarks. That battle took a while. But it was actually last night's fight with the trebuchet. That one actually put up a pretty good fight. What the hell is up with these torpedo launches? Like, some of them actually wind up landing in my ship. I have no idea how. And are my turrets jammed again? Oh, I hope not. Okay, they are not. Okay. I'll take another look at the torpedo systems. I have no idea what's going on with these torpedoes. Ooh, what's that? What have we there? Chancellor. Angler. Poseidon. Great big old sailing ship, if I remember correctly. Great big ol' FPS eating sailing ship. Yeah, that's gotta be a sailing ship. Go ahead and say hi. Well, that last test fire, you could see I was just sitting there, not moving, and one of them still went crazy high. And they were actually giving me issues even before I moved the engines down there. I think there was one battle I was camming around, and I happened to see a torpedo was laying. Yeah, I had a torpedo just sitting right in here. Just like, what the hell? You know, even with the safety fuse, the thing would have eventually timed out and detonated right in here. But at least it was not underwater. That would have hurt. I mean, seriously. Alright, cruise missiles away. Ooh. They're 2.5 kilometers out. Let's go watch some carnage. I can't help it. That's a big reason I play the game. Watching everything explode. With their torpedo buffs, torpedoes are so much fun to watch now. Once they actually start arriving, that is. But until they do, we can watch a cannon shred the ship. 160mm frag shells impacting a wooden sailing ship. Oh, jeez. It's gone. Good lord. Front to back. Oh man. Oh jeez, cruise missiles. Oh jeez. Let's see, where are the torpedoes? Torpedoes are almost here, but this one's about to die. Yeah, it's scrapping. The torpedo's helping. Oh, looks like, yep, the big one came in. Is that thing actually reaching? No, it's not. Yeah, I have no idea why it's spelled that way. I have wondered about that myself. Pretty sure this is a... Torpedoes coming in. Oh yeah. This one's actually pretty decently armored on the underside. At least for a sailing ship. Heck, why are you not moving? What are you doing? Oh, clearly know where I'm at. Trying to broadside? Can a bulldoze reach? Oh shit, yes they will. Not too much damage though. My lambs are actually shooting some of them. Well, cruise missiles away. Yeah, let's wrap this up. Yeah. Go this way. Whew. So it's out, it actually has a pretty good range broadside. Oh, now my cans are firing. And detonating their broadside. Oh, cruise missiles. It's kind of one of the big weaknesses for these ships. Yeah. Get stuff into their broadsides, they just kind of explode violently. Oh, this poor angler. Try and make it quick. What? What? No! Why are you going for the scrapping ship? Okay, pause the game and let that ship scrap. There we go.
Awaiting order.
Well, I think that just made it worse because they just hit the thing broad. Yeah, they just hit it broadside because of that. Oh, jeez. Over it goes. Wait, nope, not quite. Yep, something took a chunk out of my strategic radar. There it went. And there it goes. Ooh. That's some really nice growth on that one. And okay. If this is still Strider's territory, that means Onyx Watch headquarters is right about here. I'll go drain Icewind Boneyard, and there should be a route through the mountains in this general spot. I'll come in through there. Okay, I'm not letting the AI drive. Waters are a little treacherous around here. Okay, think I'm good. The heck? Oh shit.
Awaiting new order.
Oh shit. Freaking eerie. Okay, that might actually give me some trouble. Those things are kind of dangerous. And are quite possibly the fastest thing that the Onyx Watch actually has at a whopping 18 meters a second. Oh, nothing for it. Here goes. Definitely gonna be doing some manual driving here. Oop. Binoculars. Doing the manual aiming to end this quickly so I can get to the Eyrie. And everything's reloading.
You're in control.
Or maybe not, I don't know. Close, because when that Eyrie spawns, I don't want to be close to the Eyrie. That is their one flying unit. Cruise missile volley. Well, my lambs might be up for it. but shit, I don't know. Bloody hell. Okay, just as a temporary measure. Missile warner down right there. Looking up. So I actually have upward facing things. Missiles away. Whoop, I think I botched the aim on some of them. Nope. They're locked on. Alright, there we go. Yeah, I think I might be good. As soon as I can get those smaller cannons knocked out, those are going to be troublesome. Pretty sure I've upped the power of my LAMS system since you last watched it. Plus, as long as I don't get too terribly close, I can dodge the worst of it. Just weaving a bit. Stuff. Okay, close enough for the 5 bucks. The Erie does have its own LAMS system, but I don't think it can handle 72 missiles coming in pretty much at once. Yeah, I am planning on adding at least a few more. I just want to space them around the ship a bit more. Oh yeah, oh yeah, I think... yeah, I got this. I got this. I got this as long as I don't lose my LAMS nodes. Missile Valley. Those things take quite a while to reload. Freaking 10 block telephone poles. Got to be all kinds of torn apart by now. Oh, cutting thrust. Let's go cam over and take a look. Oh. just all kinds of shot to hell. Ooh, it's one of the turrets off entirely. Holy crap. There we go. Bloody hell, what the heck? What's that thing's percentage? 73% still. Oh shit, that big one's still firing. Not anymore. Yeah, the dedicated hover blades, as you can see there, they're actually cheating physics. They're not actually making physics calculations like regular heliblades. So right now they don't actually require any sort of clearance. They just work anywhere. Wait, am I in range? Yes, still in range. Which makes them cheaper for physics calculations. Missiles. Let's give it some more. Actually, I'm gonna have to sit here and build more resource storage or build up the ship more. I am topped up on resources. I am overflowing with resources. Oh, it's losing altitude, finally. Oh, it's going down. Lambs killed the cram shell, which detonated a few missiles. And now the torpedoes start launching. Yeah, it's dying. It's still firing, but it's still... Oh, there it went. There's the data blade still in it. Make it take off again. Good Lord, look at all those things. Let's see how much stuff is still left in the water. Not too much. All right. I am. Going to have to pull this out of play for a second to fix this jammed turret. Bloody hell. There we go. Well, this is actually a lightweight alloy, which is half the weight of wood, slightly more durable. But it has a heavy armor core. So it's actually more durable than it looks, except for right here. This is a weak spot. Get a decent sized cram or high explosive APS shell anywhere near this, and pretty much everything from here up is just gonna fall right off. Or if you get it right in on the up here, this is nowhere near as durable as well. But previous builds, I'd actually be a bit hesitant to have such obvious weaknesses, but given the volume, block count, and that's just the general size of this thing, which is going to limit how many enemies it can wind up against, I am willing to accept having some otherwise glaring vulnerabilities to offset just how freaking powerful this craft is. This thing's fucking powerful. Seriously, it's a freaking nuclear vessel. All right. Anyway, let's see. I am going to. Is this centered? This is centered. Slap some armor down over here. Yeah, the Deadly Blades, Nick and Magist were going back and forth on it, and it ultimately came down to Nick wasn't going to push Nick wasn't going to do the data blade clearance change as long as Nick, or as long as Magist didn't push for the anti-grav lift system, or something to that effect. That was according to some Nick and Magist forum posts. I'll leave that, but go right about there. What the frill? Should be good. Should be. Let's take a look down here. Turrets are not obstructed. They're not obstructed. And I still have pretty much full up on resources. Huh. The space? No idea yet. I just have not finished the hull, the exterior hull right here. Plan is to have some exterior. Hang on. Plan is to have some sort of exterior walkway, or deck or something, in this general vicinity. It will be tie in with the traversable interior that I've started working on right here. because again, the ship's so freaking powerful, I'm actually using some of the space for stuff that has absolutely no combat value. Gotta watch your step in here. This step is a little funky. You know what? I think I'll see if I can fix that. Beam, 2 meter beam. Decor, decor, stairs. Yes, there we go. Let's see, is this gonna work? Yes, okay, now it's working. There we go. Yes, well, when I did the initial framework, I may have gone just a tad large, but oh well, I'm making do. Considering this is the only ship that I'm going to have in this run through. Alright. I'm gonna go see what that incoming fleet was. Did see something somewhere, didn't I? Could have sworn. Unless that was a fleet garrisoning something somewhere. Yeah, they must have garrisoned, so I don't see them now. Huh. Right. Okay then, to the resource zone.
Moving now.
Ship, what are you doing? I have no idea. See how the propeller's doing. I need more propellers. Getting a little heavy for what's down there. Just a little heavy. Ship, why are you not stopping?
Awaiting new
oh,
orders.
Bloody hell. Ooh, what is that? That is an iron cordon. I fought one a day or two ago, and I cannot remember what the heck it looked like. Well, let's find out. And of course it spawns in the small thing first. Let's see what's over here. Oh, jeez, is that a... Not sure what this was. Culverin. Oh, hey. So that's iron cordon. Holy crap. Wait, what? Ah. Well, that's what that extra armor's for. And my lambs are still shooting some of them down, too. Some of them. We're good, I think. Yeah, we're good. I lost half the radar. Oh. Okay, we're not good. We're not good. I think I'll move now. At least the torpedo should still be firing. Yeah, let's not go closer. Yep. Still the self-guided. The shorter, smaller ones are all active radar guidance. Half of the 24 cruise missiles use the same. The other half are IR seekers with the IR camera. Which can give different targeting results on the same craft. Ah. I avoided the worst of it. Huh. Ah, there they are. Looks like the torpedoes are getting some good hits in. And you know, now I'm kind of glad I stuck the coincidence rangefinders on the turrets. So they've at least got their own backup detection ability. And I got those camera trackers on them too. Well, maybe I'll actually remember not to sit still for the next one. Oh, really? It's not like I can't afford the repairs, jeez. If the rules allowed it, I could actually build myself another copy of this ship. Still have a bit of resources left over. Fun stuff. Yeah, at some point I'm gonna have some additional sensor arrays. Well, actually that was the thing I was gonna do. There's gonna be some sensor buoy launchers. Right in this general area. For just such a scenario. A tower goes, I start deploying the sensor buoys. They'll give me radar and sonar readings. I just need to actually build them. Which I should probably do, now that I'm up against stuff that can actually knock off my radar tower. And, yeah, I only have 18 repair bots, plus my own personal repair capability, which is what those little beams are. That's my own repairing. And those are the repair bots working away. They are actually all stashed to either side right down here. I left them that nice little hole so they could get around quickly. So they actually repair faster when they have a valid path to the thing to be repaired. And I am back to 100%. All right. Let's go park on that resource on. I should probably look into adding some jets to assist with turning. So every now and then I'll bounce up just high enough that the rudders and propellers are no longer in the water. Yeah, it's just a little scuffed up. Well, damaged blocks are not repaired. It's destroyed blocks that are repaired. Oh crap, too fast, too fast. Reverse! Damn you. There we go. Oh, interesting. Somehow I'd never noticed that, the repairing damage box by pulling him out of then back into play. But not really worried about it. As soon as I get pulled into another battle, it's gonna happen anyway. So for now, I'm just gonna leave it. And I am contemplating some Graviton Ram shenanigans just so I have freaking reverse. That is not me firing my cannons. I'll still be firing a cannon, but just not those cannons. But yeah, seriously, reverse. If I could, whoops, let's see. For that, I could probably just repurpose the smoke deployer prefab. That's aimed the wrong way. There we go. Let's see, reverse, LBG. Actually, speed a little longer. Excuse me. Wait, that's not Graviton Ram. That's Graviton Ram. Probably won't be enough, but I'll I shall take a look. I could probably just downsize it and add some more ammo inputs. Get it firing more rapidly. Actually, I don't even have to downsize it. Where is the thing? Oh. Barrel cooldown time. What is that? Barrel cooldown time. That's the wrong thing. Set it to something other than G because I actually use G in build mode. Let's go with down. I don't use that for anything else. Yeah, I need some more cooldown. The reload time. I don't actually. This is actually the first time I have ever had a go at using Graviton RAM drive myself. Actually. Can help cooling by using water cooled barrel added by the decor mod. Pretty sure it's a decor mod. Which water cooled barrel reduces cooldown but is very fragile. Let's see how that works. That's actually with this, that's a 3.92 cooldown without. Oh, wait, no, that was without. Let's see what it is with. Under. Take a look at the different sizes there. Whoops. Let's see how this works. Yeah, not enough. Let's try. Let's try 120mm. should go back to 200. Actually, I can add another input feeder. By just repositioning the ACB. That should be good. Weapons when I hit down. Graviton ram reverse thruster. What the hell? Why not? Jeez. Oh, I need to mute myself a moment and take in some more cold meds. Okay. Well, the guy was originally using that because that was just had the highest armor and durability for what you're going to be shooting at, but that was because that was his system. He was using them pretty much constantly to levitate a pretty sizable battleship with graviton ram drives. This is just for the rare occasion that I actually need some reverse thrust, which does not happen all that often. And this is only going to be hitting for not much. If I was really worried about it. Just all that testing I did is just barely started to darken this metal beam. And you know what? What the hell? Why not? There. Now I really don't have to worry about it. Pretty much ever. It is far more likely that the surrounding structure will fall away before this heavy beam gives out. So silly. So silly. Alright, I'm gonna go park myself back in the resource zone. Oh, come on, game. I'm trying to exit build mode. There we go. Park myself on the resource zone, and while I am draining this, I shall build my sensor buoy launchers. There we go. All things considered, it's not that much reverse thrust, but I don't really need that much reverse thrust, and it's just enough to put get me back and away from things at low speed, which is also helped by the fact that there's very little of the ship is actually in the water, because otherwise just that one dinky little graviton ram drive would not cut it at all. And those are just backup, just in case. Okay, so sensor buoy launchers will be going atop these mountings. mesh for some of the 1 meter slope corners is farkled up. It got messed up with the last hot fix. Somebody and I have not bothered to install the community hotfix. It's not supposed to be happening. Did I set a range on the radar spin block? No, I didn't. Herp-de-derp. System in there now. Okay, controller. I will be right back. Okay, I am back. And I should probably go ahead and save. And I seem to have drifted out. the resource on. Let's make use of that graviton ram reverse and get myself back in there. Slowly. But it is a heck of a lot better than firing the cannons. Of course, the Lewis script's fighting me because it's trying to prevent my drift. Trying and failing. There we go. I'm back where I actually want to be. Let's see, is there anything dangerous around? Nothing I can see. Visual glitches. And I'm going to check Discord chat real quick. And back in game. Alright, back to the sensor buoy launchers. Popping the knuckles. I see what the fuck am I doing? I don't know. Okay, I'm doing this. Am I? Yes, this is what I'm doing. occurred to me. There's something I could do that would make these a tad bit more useful. That is, put some additional secondary sensor systems on these, and that's back too damn far. Let's move it up one block. Sensors, detection. But which one? Which one? Which one? Ow. I could just go with multiple. Why not? Maybe. Stuff going. It should probably be Ranger Barrier. Ranger Barrier. Range Angler. To slap a wireless snooper down somewhere. That'll work. Spiky ship. Oh, derp. There we go. Jeez. This game. Jeez. I have accidentally made a face of sorts. I'm gonna take a picture of this. I could just say the sub-object. That works too. Hopefully they're not too close together. That would be a bit of a pain. Oh, now I've got it built and I have it saved as a sub-object. I just shifted over a little bit. Yeah, this might be a little... might be a little too close together, but let's find out. ACBs. Their brain fart and couldn't remember where the heck they were. Pretty sure it's gonna be three with various delays. Second delay, bring it back in. Yep, I definitely want a delay on that. Okay, let's see if it works. Hit the button, it goes out. Need to increase the range on this thing. Try again. Bloody hell, can ACB still not fire weapons on spit blocks? There's plenty close enough. Ah, son of a bitch. Okay, I can work with this. I'll just set it to. I'll just set them to weapon group 5. And tweak the spin box. There are ACBs. Let's see what I want them set as. Actually, I don't even need an effect delay anymore. Spin box. This one is going to positive 45. That one is Vlad's left, yes. Yes. You. No more delays. No more delays. That should do it. And I have probably drifted off the resource zone again. Now let's test it. Hey! They actually have clearance, at least visually. And I need to remove the delays on the actual missile controllers. Probably the constraints on them too. What the hell? Aye. The hell are you being so? There we go. Back to reverse thrust. Let's see. quite the intended effect. Oh, God. I just... Oh, that's what I forgot. I completely forgot the ejectors. Oh, jeez. Oh, what the hell, one last time. Oh my god. Okay. Okay. Let's go ahead and the ejectors now. Oh, jeez. There we go. You inching forward. Get back there. Okay, let's do just a full reset and then try again. Okay, so radar tower's out. Deploy the launchers. Fire the launchers. Buoys actually clear the ship. Now what? Oh, I've got too many of them bobbing around already. That's probably what it is. Alright, let's see. Swap these out with blanks real quick. Now, without ballast tanks, they should float on the surface. Should. Unless that got changed. Well, I guess I'll find out. Let's see. Oh, shit. What the hell is that? Jeez. They broke the strategic naval pathfinding again. They're not supposed to cross land. Hey, anyway, okay, let's see. So let's go out. Things deploy. Do they actually float? Or are they gonna sink? Oh, those are floating. Okay, those are bobbing on the surface correctly. Where are those buoys? Yeah, they should be good. So then, buoys deployed. Bring the launchers back in. Or, hell, I could just leave them out and actually get a little extra detection going out there. But for now, I don't need them. Just leave them there. Switch these back to these sensors. Adjusted. Time to get up and move. Like the game's doing that stutter again. That game has been running too long, stutter. Fun. Okay, stream is going to pause or go down briefly while I restart the game. Be right back.